इफ एप्साइलन इक्वल टू बीटा वन बीटा टू बीटा आर वेयर बीटाज आर टू साइकिल एंड ऑल्सो टू साइकिल्स वी कॉल ट्रांसपोजिशन देन आर इज इवन दैट मीन द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ ट्रांसपोजिशन आर ट्रांसपोजिशन इज एप्साइलन देन आर विल बी इवन identity where epsilon is identity. So first we understand the concept. What is the epsilon? Epsilon mean identity and two cycle mean a permutation defined on two element, that is like AB, a permutation defined on AB. In expanded form we write it A goes to B and B goes to A. This is two cycle, or also two cycle we call transposition. So before we do this result, We understand some other concepts regarding the two cycles, product of two cycles. If we consider a set S containing element A, B, C, D, suppose up to Z, then the identity defined on this element is written like this: A goes to A, B goes to B, C goes to C, and in last Z goes to Z. That means it is like the identity function. That means fx goes to x. Image and pre-image same. So this is identity. If I consider a smaller case, if I take S is equal to suppose only two element AB, then obviously identity is A goes to A, B goes to B. This identity we write sometime A goes to A like this, only one symbol we note here, or sometime like one. So this means this is identity, but if we take a two cycle, this is obviously not two cycle because it is identity. So this is we write like this. So it does not move on the two elements, that's why it is not a two cycle. So consider a two cycle. So consider two cycle, obviously this is two cycle because this is a cycle. That means this is A, B, A goes to B and B goes to A like this. A goes to B, that means in expanded form we write it A goes to B, B goes to A. So this is a cycle, but obviously this cycle is not identity. So how we can make this identity? First thing, obviously it is like the real numbers. X, if not one identity, then how we can make X identity? If we multiply X with its inverse, then it is identity. So same case here, to make it identity. So here one thing we can conclude also, if this is one cycle, that means R is one, and we take this, if we take AB is equal to beta 1, and obviously or clearly R here is 1, which is odd number, and for odd number we can see that for R1 beta 1 is not identity, hence this result is not true, hence above result is not true for R is equal to 1. So now this beta 1 when become identity, if I multiply it with its inverse, so AB, if I multiply with its inverse, it become identity. And because we know that AB is equal to BA, because it is a cycle, so in cycle we can move from A to B or B to A, it remains cycle. So this I can write AB is equal to BA. Obviously, if you want to multiply, you want to check it, easily can be checked. This first mean A goes to B, B goes to A, and second mean B goes to A, A goes to B. So if I take product, A goes to B and B goes to A, that means here this goes to B, and then here B goes to A. Similarly, B goes to A and A goes to B. This is identity. That means the result is true for R2. So we notice for R equal to 2, result is true, right? Now similarly we check for R3 what happens. If I take S is equal to, if S is ABC, only three element, then one happen. Obviously, I take a permutation ABC, and ABC, a permutation or cycle, I write in terms of transposition AC, AB. AC, AB. So this is obviously not identity, because this become identity if their images are same. Therefore this cycle when it become identity, if I multiply with its inverse, ABC, ABC inverse is equal to identity, and this mean ABC is equal to CBA. CBA. Now in terms of transposition, if I write, then this become AC and this become AB, and for this become CA and CB. Now how we can make it identity? We make the pair so that one pair become identity. We see this is AC, this and this become identity, but actually they are far. So first we have to make this CA, we move this CA toward the left. How we can move? So we consider these two factors, these two factors, these two transposition. Now AB, CA, actually it is what? It is, I can write AB, AC, because the transposition I can write, because we know that AB is equal to BA. Already we have discussed. So this become AB, AC. Now, if I make the cycle of these two transposition, then it become A, C, B, right? This mean this is a cycle. Suppose this is A, this is C, this is B. So this move from A to C, C to B, B to A. Like this, it is a cycle. I can, actually I wanted to move this, this CA factor I want to bring on the left side. So how I can make, that mean this AC I have to make this side. So I can make this, if I write, I take this there, then this become, if I start from here, then it become B, A, C. But still our purpose is not solved. So I make one more rotation of the circle. I write it A, I write C. That means I start from here, C to B to A. That means one circle I move, it does not change. Either I start from A to C, C to B, B to A, or I start from C. Initial point I can change, but I have to keep these things in order. Now, this become, if I write this cycle in the transposition, this become CA, CB, CA, CB. That means this AB, CA, I can write equal to CA, CB, CA, CB. That means this factor can be replaced by CA, CB. Therefore, this become this AC as it is, and this AB, ABCA can be replaced by CA, CB, and the last factor is CB. Now you see, this is identity, and this is also identity, right? These both are identity. And finally, I get identity. That mean, this is the case. If I start from here, that mean, now I consider this part. That mean, so from here, AC, AB, CA, CB is identity. This is identity. How I made? Just by moving this transposition toward the left here. This becomes identity. That means this is true. So above result, result is true for R4. It is again even. Similarly, we can extend. So here, what we conclude? We conclude that in product of in product of two cycles, we make pair of transposition or two cycle with its inverse so that it become identity. And also we learn from this result that a cycle, if it is not making pair, then we can move it left or right, any side. Like here, this factor pair up with this factor, but because this is not along with, so we have to learn the technique how we can bring this factor on the left side so it become identity. So here now we start the theorem. Simple, I hope it is understood easy. Proof. Clearly, R cannot be 1, R not equal to 1, since if R is equal to 1, then we have identity is equal to beta 1. That means identity is equal to 1 2 cycle, and a 2 cycle, and we know a 2 cycle is not identity. Right? So, again, if R is equal to 2, then result is true, because we have to prove even, then we have done when this can happen. This can happen that beta 2 is inverse of beta 1. Right? Now suppose R greater than 2, and we proceed by induction, mathematical induction. So for R2 is it true? So consider one more thing we know. Since we know AB is equal to BA, this is easy to show, because already I have showed that this means a cycle of two element, that means A goes to B and B goes to A. So if I take initial point B, then B goes to A and A goes to B. So it is not a difference, because circle has no end and no initial, the beginning point. So circle has no end, that's why this we can write, we can start from A to B or B to A. So it is a continuous process circling. Therefore, this AB is equal to BA. So consider first two transposition. So Y, considering first two transposition. Oh my God. First two transposition. Beta 1, beta 2. Transposition we observe, following cases. Number one case, first two transposition beta 1, beta 2, if I take, it is something like this, AB, AB, then it is obviously identity. If only two case on two element, then it is identity. Second thing, if it is on three element, then it is something like that. Already we have discussed in the example, then this is AB, AC, and this we have proved that this is equal to BC, equal to AB. That means we can move from this example, we learn that this AB can be moved right. How we can do this? This is simple. This mean AB, AC mean this is a cycle of three element and this is ACB, ACB, and ABC, AC is ACB. ACB can be rotated. After rotation, I can write like I want to be BC. That means B I want to place here and C I want to place here. Then I can move this B, A, C, and this I can write BC, BA, and this is BC, AB, because AB from here, AB is equal to BA. So how this come, already we have discussed, because it is a cycle. So it is on three element, this is A, this is C, this is B. Here is the initial point, A goes to C, C goes to B, B goes to A. And in this, the initial point I am taking this, B goes to A, because the direction remains same. Direction remains same. B goes to A goes to C, C goes to B. So now just changing the initial point, we can write this equal to this. And from this, we can write this thing. And here we can notice that this AB can be moved to the right side. Similarly, for three element, how we can do this? The third observation, if the two cycle are like this, AB, CD. So in this case, these are disjoint because they don't have common element. So it is easy, because we know that the disjoint cycles or disjoint permutations are commutative. So this is simply we can replace CD is equal to AB. And now AB, BC, equal to BC AC. That means this BC, we want to move this transposition, we want to move on left. So we consider this factor. This factor means AC, this factor actually here B is twice, that mean this mean we consider AB equal to BC. First I have to write this BA BC, and this mean BCA. This is like this. Now, because I want to see at two places, that means I want to bring C first, then I move this. This A is moved here, then it become A, B, C. But our purpose is not solved. Then I move one more step because C is in the two transposition. So C should be first. C I bring here, then this becomes C, A, B. And now I break in transposition, then this become CB equal to CA, and this easily I can write BC and AC. So this factor I can move like this. Actually these all results come from, because a cycle, we did a theorem before this, how cycle is written in the form of, in the product of transposition. From that means if our this is a cycle A2, A3, AK, then the transposition we write A1, AK, A1, AK minus 1, and the last factor is A1, A2, like this. This is one way, but it is not unique. Another way also there, this we can write also A1, A2, A2, A3, A3, A4, and this is AK minus 1, AK. This is also one way. So this is not unique, but we more commonly, this we are using here, this way of the decomposition of a cycle in the transposition. So this is the product how we are using. So out of these observations we made, we notice that one transposition can be moved either on the left side or right side. Actually, it will help us to make the pair of a transposition with its counterpart, right? So that the one transposition, if we pair with its inverse, then it become identity, and each transposition we make like this identity, and finally we get this identity, right? Now, if beta 1, beta 2 are like first case, then we can delete. The first case was what? First case was beta 1, beta 2 is equal to epsilon. This was the first case. Then beta 1, beta 2 can be, so okay, I move this, then beta 1, beta 2 can be removed. Why? Because beta 1, beta 2 become identity, and identity multiplying with any element, it does not change the actual product. So the remaining, that means if the first two, if it is identity, we remove, then we remain with how many transposition? R minus 2. R minus 2. Right? Removed, we can then, beta can be removed from original product and we obtain what? We obtain epsilon is equal to beta 3, beta 4 and last is beta r. Now how many? These are r minus 1 transposition. So, and by principle of mathematical induction, by principle of mathematical induction, R minus 2 is even. Otherwise what happens if it is not identity? Otherwise we can replace, or we replace simply beta 1, beta 2 on left side, on left side by its counterpart. Counterpart is inverse. Counterpart on the right, on right side. To obtain a new product, okay, now I move up. Product of R transposition or R two cycles. Till it become identity. That is, or if beta 1, beta 2 is not identity, we move beta 1 to right side using above method till we find some beta I such that beta 1 beta I is equal to epsilon. That means this beta 1 if not making identity, that means if beta 1 not making identity with beta 2, then we move beta 1 to our left side. So somewhere we will find some beta I with which, if it is paired, it become identity, right? So in this way, again we obtain product of r minus 2 two cycles. Why we will find? Certainly we will find some beta I, such that beta 1 beta I is equal to identity. Otherwise if beta I not exist, then what happen? Otherwise if no such beta I exist, then beta 1 cannot be identity. Therefore, beta 1, beta 2, beta r, if one element do not have, that means one transposition not have its counterpart, then obviously this product will not have, will become identity. And that will give the result is completely untrue. Right, and in this case what will happen? Definitely this r will be odd number. Then obviously r is odd, which contradict, right? So there will be definitely some beta I where beta 1 will make identity. So this is the theorem.